Welcome back to State of the Union. I'm Jake Tapper. President Trump is defending the immigration raids in Mississippi this week, in which at least 680 people were detained, leaving some children crying out for their parents. The president says those raids were a very good deterrent to those considering crossing into the U.S. illegally. Joining me now, the acting commissioner of U.S. Customs and Border Protection, Mark Morgan. Thank you so much for joining us. I want you to take a listen to one 11-year-old girl whose father was detained in these Mississippi raids.
I need my dad for me. My dad didn't do nothing. He's not a criminal. Governments, please put your heart. Let my parents be free with everybody else, please. Don't leave the child with crying and everything.
Now, you and the president said just a few weeks ago that the pending ICE raids coming down the pike were going to be focused on violent criminals. That's not what happened here in Mississippi. Why not?
Well, so first of all, I've never said that the raids, as you call it, were focused on violent criminals. I've never said that. And also, I think words matter. These aren't raids. These are targeted in law enforcement operations. And in this case, this was a joint criminal investigation with ICE and the Department of Justice targeting worksite enforcement, meaning companies that knowingly and willfully hire illegal aliens so that in most cases they can pay them reduced wages, exploit them further for their bottom line. That's what this investigation was about, a criminal investigation, Jake.
All right, so I want to get to that in 1 second,
sure.
But just to give your exact quote, you're right, you didn't say violent. You said, quote, their part has always been and it will be to go after those that are criminal aliens, meaning those people that are here illegally and have committed additional crimes against American citizens.
So that was my response to a question about priorities. And the ICE's priorities will always be to go after criminal aliens as a priority. That doesn't mean they exclude all demographics. We still have to apply consequences, meaning enforce the rule of law for those individuals that are here illegally against immigration law.
So it seems like undocumented workers, the dad of that little girl and the like, often bear the brunt of these raids and not the employers who hire them. Is it important to hold businesses responsible for this? Researchers at Syracuse University found that from April 2018 to March 2019, the Trump administration prosecuted zero companies and only 11 individuals for employing undocumented immigrants. Obviously, hundreds of thousands of undocumented immigrants have been targeted.
So think about what you're saying, Jake. So you're saying on one hand that we're not doing enough, and then when we go out and we actually do what you're saying we need to do more of, they're chastised for doing that.
Well, I'm saying, why aren't you focusing more on the companies and the business owners?
They are. Again, this was a joint criminal investigation between ICE and the Department of Justice, which was targeting the companies that were hiring illegal aliens.
Are there any charges against the companies or the business owners?
It's a pending investigation right now. There's a criminal search warrant to go in there to collect more information, more intelligence, and that investigation is ongoing. But that's the intent of that investigation.
Is it important for businesses to not employ these individuals who are in this country illegally and exploit them, as you suggested?
Absolutely. But it's twofold. So I think the American people need to understand that's exactly what's happening. So these individuals seeking a better life first are being exploited by the cartels to come here.
Right.
Once they come into the United States, then they're further exploited by United States companies by paying them reduced wages. But that's only the first element of this. These individuals here, and the girl, I know it's emotional. I know it's done on purpose to show a picture like that.
What's done on purpose?
But to show the girl. Jake, listen.
Just people in the wake of these raids, yeah, we interview people who are affected by them.
But how about interview the people that, because a majority of time in these cases, these individuals that are here illegally, they also steal identities of U.S. citizens. They get fraudulent documents, Social Security cards, and et cetera. And so it's not just a victimless crime that's going on here. First of all, they are here illegally, and then a lot of times there's additional fraud that goes with this for them to try to get these jobs in these companies. So I understand that the girl's upset, and I get that. But her father committed a crime. And just so the American people know also, is that girl, her mother was home and she was reunited with her mother within a few hours that night.
I want to ask you because I mean, you're talking about how this is a pending investigation into these businesses, but we see the human cost of this borne by the undocumented immigrants and their families over and over and over again. And like I just gave you the statistic from Syracuse, in the last year, zero companies prosecuted, only 11 individuals prosecuted. If you focused on the companies, wouldn't that have more of a deterring effect than going after these individuals who are desperate?
So Jake, again, I this is the third time. That was the intent of the investigation.
But I'm talking about in the last year, only zero companies and 11 individuals for the last year.
I can't speak to the Department of Justice on how many cases they have. I'm the commissioner of CBP, so I'm not involved in those investigations. But what I can tell you is that's exactly what this investigation was about. And again, let's go back to words matter. These aren't undocumented immigrants. They are illegal immigrants. They are here in this country illegally. They're obtaining jobs illegally. So I think words matter. And let's keep in mind that ICE, and during this target enforcement operation, they took extraordinary efforts to make sure that when everyone that was apprehended, they actually had agents dedicated full-time during this operation, that they did nothing but be prepared to reach out to schools, to reach out to daycare. And every single person that they apprehended, the first question that they asked was, do you have a child? Where are they? Are they at daycare or are they at school? They had phone banks there for everybody to call to reach out to their loved ones and their children. Again, these agents contacted over 12 schools. And they made sure that they were had a full understanding of where everybody else. And that's why over 300 of the 600 plus that were arrested were reunited on humanitarian reasons because they had kids, they had children, they were released on their own and were cognizant.
So the Washington Post reported this week that at least 8 Trump Organization properties have employed, whether you call them illegal immigrants or undocumented immigrants. And this is just one of many, many headlines about undocumented immigrants working for President Trump's properties, whether it's his construction crews, working at his properties, working at his golf clubs. There have been zero raids on any of these companies despite headline after headline after headline. It seems like you guys are turning a blind eye to this crime being committed by the president's own companies.
So, look, I've been in law enforcement for over 25 years. So first of all, again, I'm the commissioner of CBP, so it's not my responsibility.
I understand. You were head of ICE, though, until recently.
That's correct. What I can tell you is that in my 25 years, I take offense to say anybody's turning a blind eye to someone that is violating the law. I've been doing it for a long time. I've never known anybody in law enforcement to turn a blind eye to someone that's committing a crime.
Well, I don't understand why it is that the president's companies, there's headline after headline after headline about them employing undocumented immigrants, and there's never been a raid, there's never been any sort of law enforcement investigation that we can discern.
Well, so you really can't say that for sure, because there are investigations going on all the time that you're unaware of, and we shouldn't be aware of those investigations. So those investigations should be done without notifying everyone, because of course it's going to jeopardize the investigation if I come on here and I talk to you about an investigation that's going on.
The number of arrests along the U.S.-Mexico border fell 24% last month to its lowest mark since February. It's almost been cut in half since the high in May. That's a success. Yet you still call this a, quote, full-blown crisis this week. At what point is it no longer a full-blown crisis if you're halving the number?
So that's great, Jake, and I think that's a good question. We can't be focused on the number alone. Again, 43% reduction from May, that's absolutely a huge step, and that's because of this president and what this administration is doing, especially with our international partners. The efforts now from the government of Mexico and the government of Guatemala is unprecedented, and that's one of the major reasons why we're seeing these apprehension numbers go down. But make no mistake, our daily apprehension numbers are still, we're between 23 to 2,500. If you remember, the former Secretary Jay Johnson said a bad day for him was 1,000.
Yeah.
And I know it because I worked for him then as Chief of Border Patrol. So this is still crisis levels. And here's a key point. It's not just the numbers. It's the demographics. Again, things have changed. These are
families
and income minors, right? 65% of which we're allowing them in the country. That adds to the crisis. It's not just
I want to ask just a follow on that, because almost 30,000 undocumented immigrants have been sent back to Mexico to wait for their immigration hearings, part of this new deal you have with the Mexican government. But they are being sent to some very dangerous cities, Tijuana, for example. And the group Human Rights First said there are 110 public reports of rape, kidnapping, and other violent crimes against asylum seekers waiting in Mexico. That's likely just the tip of the iceberg. Are you worried at all that this process is resulting in sending people back over the border into Mexico, into dangerous cities, basically sending them to their doom?
So I disagree with that categorization that we're sending anybody to their doom. First of all, for any country, the safety and security of the citizens of the country, for any country is a challenge. Look at the cities in our own country. Jake, we have multiple cities in our country where the homicide rate per capita is outrageous. Violent crime is outrageous. Would it be fair to say that the entire United States is a dangerous country? I think not. And I think so we need to be cautious about overcharacterizing and overgeneralizing how dangerous Mexico is.
I just meant the two cities, Tijuana, and the other one's escaping my memory. What are the three cities, the main ones that they're going to? They're going to Tijuana.
I don't know the major cities that they're going to right now because we're expanding.
But I'm only talking about these cities that are very dangerous. But we're out of time. Right. I appreciate your time, Commissioner Morgan. Thank you so much for being here. I appreciate it.
You bet. Thanks, sir.